Hey Airsofters, welcome to another episode of Airsoft Mandalorian. We are playing OSG Paintball in New Durham, New Hampshire. This is another round from Operation Independence. I am using my Thompson submachine gun and my Glock 18 sidearms, made by CYMA. Right now, the gameplay is Cowboys versus Indians, obviously in Western Town. Right now, my team is acting as the Indians, and so far has made okay progress getting into the town, but unfortunately, the Cowboys have put up a very stiff resistance. Unfortunately, one of the players in the top of the church building is, yes, you guessed it, the Polish Star player that has his gun running a bit too hot. He has it on 7-round burst, but 7-round burst on a Polish Star, it might as well be full auto, because you can just trigger spam it, and it's just full auto, and you're just saying 7-round burst to make everyone feel better. But anyways, just gotta medic this guy, and then we're gonna try to make a push up to the back of church, and hopefully be able to take out the guy in the top, and hopefully, you know, there's a lot of hopefullys, be able to cut off the respawn, and then hopefully be able to win the match. So let's see how this hopefully goes.
All right, guys, stop shooting. We got one. I got CJ, you little son of a gun. Move around this side, move around this side. Watch that.
You're done.
You're out. Yeah, it's Polar Star.
He's right in that building.
Where?
Throw a grenade.
Yes?
Where do we have on our top side?
Oh, yeah, again, Polar Star.
Yeah, Polar Star.
Oh, get up, get up, get up. You're out! You in the building, you are out!
Hey!
He's out of there. Okay, guys, just wake up.
Someone who's at that building.
I know where he is. He's right tucked into that corner. We need guys, like one after another, just going up there.
Up there?
Yeah.
Is he up there?
Where? Norgot. Five, eight, nine, ten. Okay, use your body shield. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Use your body shield. He's right there. Jeez, get down, get down, get down. You hit?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He's moving. Jeez. Careful. Careful. Gotcha.
Yes, I did hit him, but not first. He did technically hit me first, and I hit him second because I took the time to sweep the corner first before I shot over there because I thought he was originally in the corner. So the ref said, yeah, you got hit first, so just go back and respawn behind the building, as you see these points, and call it good. So I'm like, hey, I'll take it, so let's take it on.
We can respawn right here. We can't.
Now, you guys might think it was kind of mean to shoot those two players like the way I did, one in the head and the one in the leg, but those two guys were not calling their hits. If you remember when we first stormed this building, the guy right at the corner was like, hey guys, I just shot you, and then I even threw a hand grenade in there. Well, those guys didn't count that hit. One of them did, but there were still two in there who didn't call themselves out, so they kind of brought it upon themselves. If I thought about it, you know, I would have thrown another hand grenade in, but I didn't want to get it all muddy because it was kind of wet in there, so I did what I did, and they kind of brought it upon themselves for not calling the hit, so... that's that.
Whoa, jeez.
Okay, the result of us taking the church is that now we have turned off the Cowboys respawn. So, with the rest of my team, I'm going to try to push the enemies back to the general store, which is always the last, if you will, refuge of the Cowboys, and then we are going to make an effort to push up the stairs and hopefully kill everyone in the upper story, and if we are able to accomplish this, we will have won the match. So, let's see if we're able to accomplish this valiant feat of arms, if you will, whatever. Let's just get back to the game. I'm going to shut up now.
Who's in there? Okay, do you guys? I'm good. I didn't know who's in there. Oh. Let me just kick it out of the way.
That grenade, I just kicked it twice.
Okay, it's not gonna go off. Guys, let's move. Medic. Ah, jeez. Dan, I got hit. Dan, get out of here.
Hit.
Damn you.
Oh, damn.
Should've got that on video. I know.
Okay, that part right there is kind of confusing. I did not actually get hit. I was saying I got hit. I got kind of confused. I was trying to say that there was a guy there because a player had been hit that was standing there. So trying to warn Dan to move, but obviously he got hit, but then I healed him. But I was not hit, so I was not cheating by healing Dan or that other player. Just want to clarify that because it got kind of confusing there with me saying, Dan, I got hit. I did not mean to say I was hit, another player was. Just wanted to clarify that.
What? Yeah, I see him. Yeah, I see him. Boop, boop, boop. What? You hit? Guys, we need more people. Guys, we need more people. Okay, let's go. North guard, you and me. I got hit in the knee just as he said game over.
Amazing.
We're just like, ah!
Best bridge ever.
That was awesome, guys. That was awesome. Boom!
Well, guys, that ends another episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. Definitely was a lot of fun. You know, we did pretty good. We won in under 15 minutes, so that was a lot of good times. One thing you guys might be wondering is, why don't we ever just chuck a hand grenade up there and get all those guys out who are holding up a story? Well, there is a rule. You can't use hand grenades to get them out. You have to shoot them with your guns, which I completely understand that. That's a pretty good rule. I mean, what's the point of even being up there? Someone just can be like, oh, a grenade, and then what's the point of that? But, you know, it's kind of annoying when you're the ones attacking, but you're very grateful for that rule when you're defending. But, you know, it's not very often the Cowboys win. I've only ever seen them win once, but I do have that game on camera, so it's definitely worth watching, so stay tuned for that. There's only one more episode from this operation, so I hope you guys can make it for that one. Another thing I want to clarify is that I did not mean to overshoot those kids in the top of that building. We had literally had three people shooting in there at once, and everyone's like, oh, look out in the corner, and then, oh, look at that. So I just kind of went in there and just sprayed the whole room down, and I did not mean to shoot the ref in the back, but like, I felt so bad about that, and I did go back and apologize. I was like, I'm really sorry about shooting the back of the leg. That was not intentional. He's like, okay, you know, that's okay. So that was all good. So thanks for watching another episode of Airsoft Mandalorian. Please subscribe, like, and leave your comments below. And until next time, don't forget, get out there and play. And bang, there goes a grenade.